I will put it back there.
Hello. So, one quick question for the next speakers. Can you please identify yourself towards us then? So, Karen? Karen, who's the next one?
Sarah Jane.
So, if you're around, then please come to Karen. So, our next speaker here is Luca Bonisi, and he will talk about one topic. When I first saw what he was accomplishing there as one person, it was amazing. So, and the rest he will talk about, but yeah, it's amazing what one person was able to do there.
Hello, welcome to Fosman, and welcome to this talk. This talk is about the right to install any software on your device, on your own device, and consequently, what in my opinion is an unlawful behavior to install, to pre-install software on PC that you normally bought in your device. Specifically, the software are Windows, proprietary software that are Windows and Office. I briefly introduced myself. Okay, the images. Sorry. Because the images are missing. I briefly introduce myself. My name is Luca Bonisi. I came from Italy. My main job is developing firmware of electronic devices, and I also support some school and small office with free software, especially one school that I defined a free software school where all teachers and students are using free software. I have some hobbies that are always related to free software. Audio and video, I am audio and video technicians, where I use Ardour, Jack, Jamin, Sinodera, KPDN Live. I play guitar and piano. And you use Rose Garden as a MIDI player to record from piano. I like to observe celestial object like the ISS. This image is the ISS photographed by me with a normal camera. I built a 3D printer, and I using them for mainly for repairing or also for fun. I make some free software project or activity. One is to make a chord on the text of songs, since I play piano and guitar, and transpose it automatically. Another is I'm the maintainer of the unofficial porting of Slackware GNU/Linux distribution for many platforms and CPUs. A project that I just started is to free your Android TV box. I bought a cheap Android TV box and I installed Linux to be used as a general purpose devices. And I am a volunteer of in the FSV as a translator. For FSV, I built this project that was built in Perl, a language that maybe not so used, but I love it. I built this program to help translator in FSV, to help translation in the FSV, the translation process, so the translator has not to care about the HTML formatting and so on. I contribute also at this fantastic book. I maintain the Git repository of this free software book. Free software means that this book is distributed with the free license. And it was translated in 5 languages actually. German, Ukrainian, Italian, Arabic, and English. The Italian book is not yet published, but we wish it will be soon published. And if you like this book, you can attend the reading of the book this evening at 6 p.m. And Matthias will be the reader, I think. Okay. Bonus hobby, I make ice creams. Since the book talk also about ice cream, it is very related to my hobby. And if you are curious, you go to UB2 this evening. In this presentation you will find many illustrations like the one on the right that come from the book, so I sponsor a little bit the book. Okay, we start with the real presentation. Legal basis about the device neutrality and Windows refund. We have two different contracts. One is for the hardware and one is for the software. This contract cannot be joined together. You cannot force to join the two contracts and force to give back also the hardware if you ask for the refund. The hardware contract is a sales and purchase agreement. You become the ownership of the product, of your PC, of the product, and nobody can force you to do what you don't want to do. Instead, the software is a license agreement. You have a right to use the software under some condition that for proprietary software like Windows and Office are limitations. Yeah. Instead, for free software are freedoms. I talk about device neutrality. Because you own the hardware and you have the right to choose to install what software you like. Also by installing free software on your device, you gain the sovereignty of your device. proprietary software, you don't know what proprietary software make on your device, what proprietary software connect to some site that you don't know. Running free software can overcome software obsolescence, because especially with the newer version of proprietary software, you are forced to change your hardware, because the newer version of proprietary software doesn't run on older hardware. Instead, free software you can customize, like I do with the TV boxes, and run also on lower-end devices. And in this way, you extend the hardware lifetime, and also you reduce the electronic impact of host. There is also an open letter that the Free Software Foundation Europe asked to sign for the right to install any software on any device. The link is this one, maybe it will be available later. Free Software Foundation Europe asked to the European Parliament and Commission, and also to public administration, to be able that every device should be independent of from the software it runs. Because using open standards and open interfaces. This is related to our talk because sometimes hardware manufacturers use proprietary interface that limit the possibility to use some feature of your device. Okay, we come first of all technical hurdles. Manufacturers say this is real what Microsoft says from a device I purchase, for the laptop surface I purchase. Microsoft says that the device would not work properly with other operating system, and they are not supported. This is said by Microsoft. And this is true, because my laptop surface, the touch screen doesn't work, the webcam doesn't work with GNU Linux due to proprietary interface of this device. Also, installing from scratch GNU Linux is not straightforward because the keyboard and the touchpad doesn't work if you don't build a customized kernel. The drivers for keyboard and touchpad are not in the main line, but okay, you can compile and then it works. The manufacturer could also lock the bootloader. For example, Microsoft with ARM devices and Windows 8 locked the secure boot in a way that you cannot install software different than Microsoft Windows. So the device is not really your. Because you can only run software certified by another party. We come to legal hardware. Manufacturers often say that even if the license say that you must contact the manufacturers, manufacturer says that you have to ask the refund to the vendor or to Microsoft, but this is not true because the license agreement says that you have to contact the manufacturer. Manufacturer says that you must also return the PC, So you should have all the full of all PC, both PC and the software. My father said you can't have only the software refund. Manufacturer set a very little time span to ask for the refund, usually only 30 days. Manufacturing says that you must prove you refuse the license, but it is impossible to prove you refuse the license because when you start for the first time Windows, you have only one button, accept. You cannot even power down the PC, especially if it is a laptop, it could be a problem because the battery is integrated, usually integrated, and you cannot power off the PC if you don't know that you have to press the power button for 30 seconds. Recently, a manufacturer switched their policy and say that you must return the PC to their laboratory because you must remove the product key, that is an information of about the Windows license in the stored in the BIOS. And manufacturers set a price by your own, not the market price of the Windows license. Okay, when I started, when you first run the PC to see the license agreement, because to refuse the license agreement, you have to see the license agreement. With the latest Windows version, it is mandatory to connect your PC to internet before viewing the license agreement. I think this could be not compliant to the GDPR because your PC sends information to manufacturer and to Microsoft sites without your explicit agreement. There is no refuse button, as I already said. And you cannot install a different license. If you remove Windows and you download Microsoft Windows from Microsoft website and you want to install a full license or also the gratis license, because Windows is gratis. This is only a limitation that you cannot customize the toolbar. You cannot do it because when you install the version you downloaded for the internet, it looks for the product key. So you are in your short circuits. Okay, very briefly, cases of refund in Italy. There was a case in 2005 against HP. The case came to the Supreme Court of Italy, and that say the refund must be given. It what about nine years it last to all the cycle. The second case is similar. It takes also 9 years. It's very similar. And this case is regarding this PC. Okay. And I request the refund in 2018. Lenovo refused categorically the refund of the only software. They asked that they say that I have to return also the PC. But I filed a court case by myself without a lawyer initially, because from my side it was clear that Lenovo has wrong. But Lenovo introduce artificial complexity so that they cannot I cannot continue without a lawyer. So I asked for a lawyer. I win the first grade lawsuit, but Lenovo immediately filed the second grade the appeal, the second grade lawsuit, and they lost the second grade, but the judge of Monza Court imposed to Lenovo punitive damages of 20,000 euros because they use the legal instruments with bad faith, without any valid reason. Okay, after these cases, I requested also other with refund. The case were, was simpler, but not so easy. Acer, for example, asked to return the PC for to remove the product key. And in this case, since I have some front-end, excessive front-end of my, I go to bike to with the bike to bring the, my PC to Acer. There are also other cases, one from with Microsoft, as I already said. One with HP, I filed a court case against HP. They lost the court case, but in this case the judge does not recognize to me the legal fee, so the balance was the same. I lost what I gained from the refund. Other cases, okay. I go. This is interesting. The last year with Acer, because when I asked to Acer this time, I need the PC immediately, so I cannot wait to send the PC to Acer and to give it back. And Acer said that it was Microsoft that asked to send the PC to the manufacturer to remove the product key. Then I filed a court case, but it was stopped by Acer before saying before reaching the first hearing. So they give me 129 euros. Latest case with against with Lenovo that was terminated 3 days ago. Lenovo says again that you must return the PC to the manufacturer, and they say that they are not satisfied by the license. The license they propose, they are not satisfied by the license they themselves propose, so it is not very coherent. Okay, asking for the refund, I go very quickly. You have to power on the PC, you have to read the license, contact the manufacturer, send email, and a certified email in Italy, and you have to be very patient, because maybe many mails you have to send before requesting the refund, before having the refund, but you will have the refund. Okay, one important thing is that manufacturers artificially increase the cost of the PC with a mandatory payment to Microsoft. I think that if you obtain the refund, you must you have to give part of the refund to some free software organization. I give all 20,000 euros to this association. And if you want to donate, you can go to the link down, and if you can support the Free Software Foundation for their valuable work. Thank you.
Is substantially lower than the pickup on that one.